Okay, and welcome to Going Native number 63. As always, I'm Steve Carroll. I'm the dev manager of the C++ team here at Microsoft. And with me today, we believe a new person. Yeah, you're new. Not new to the team.
Gotten.
Right, so you've blocked out any previous Going Native.
I could have tried to wipe this from my memory if I've done this before, yes.
Who are you?
I'm Andrew Pardoe. I'm the program manager for the MSVC compiler toolset.
Okay, and so what our topic for today is the build tool SKU of Visual Studio. I think we introduced it for the first time in 2015. So let's start with something easy. Andrew, I'll toss you a softball to get started. What is the build tool SKU?
So the build tools is basically the same tool sets as you get with Visual Studio, but without installing the Visual Studio IDE.
So you say tool set, and I think that might be jargon we use. What do we mean by that?
The compiler, the libraries, MS build, everything that you need to build your code from the command line or CMake or whatever your build system is.
Right. So I guess the problem we're hoping that we can solve for folks today is sort of like, if you need to install Visual Studio to get just the compilers.
Right.
Today we're hoping that you'll leave this episode knowing all the different ways that you can do that, right?
Right. If you've got a CI server or a build server somewhere, you don't need to install the entire IDE.
But you used to.
You used to, yes. Up until 2015, you had to install the entire IDE.
Right.
In 2015, we hacked together a build tools to kind of prove out the concept. The installer was not good. The installer was not designed for the build tools. So in 2017, with the new VS installer, the lightweight installer, one of the things that we did was we designed the build tools in. So one of the other points is that if you're still using the VS 2015 build tools, you should move off from that to the VS 2017 build tools. It's the same tool set, the compiler, the libraries, et cetera. It just uses the VS 2017 installer.
So I think regardless of the version of Visual Studio, as long as it is 2015 or 2017, you want to use the 2017
build tools. Right.
And if you're on Visual Studio 2013, you should quickly upgrade to Visual Studio 2017. So what can you use this to install? Like we covered that it installs the compiler. We covered that it installs the libraries. But like, what else can it do?
It installs all of the desktop workloads for C++, which is the only language that matters. It also installs the .NET workloads.
If that's how you roll.
If you're still on C#. So the build tools install all of the workloads of Visual Studio, all of the native workloads like C#. I believe that everything that is in Visual Studio is either in the build tools or slated to go into the build tools. The C++ desktop workloads are there.
Yeah.
Obviously, some things like the mobile targeting, it doesn't make much sense to have build tools for that. That's an IDE-bound experience. UWP, similarly, is more of a, you need the XAML compiler and all of that. But if they have desktop workloads, they are completely there.
Right. So I think our intention here is that if you have a build server that you are trying to provision using the build SKUs, and what you need is something that you would have normally used the Visual Studio installer, and it's not there yet, by all means, contact us. Yeah, let us know.
Send mail to Steve.
Yes, two R's, two L's, and an O, not an E.
There you go.
Yes. Nothing against Steve Carroll. It's not. I don't personally.
He's funnier.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Anyways. Okay. So that is the build tool SKU.
Yes.
Where do you get the build tool SKU?
Where do you get the build tool SKU? It is actually at the bottom of the page under the same page that you use to install Visual Studio. If you can't find that yourself, you can go to a web browser and type aka.ms/buildtools, one word.
Okay, great. And I'm assuming we'll put some screenshots up in here.
Ooh, screenshots.
Yeah, it's great. I think you can also use it to install other things that might be very convenient to folks, right? Like, I think you can get the SDK this way, too.
You can get the Windows SDK.
And you can still choose what you want to install.
Yes, it is just like the regular Visual Studio installer, except it does not have an option to install the IDE. So the regular VS installer, you don't have an option to not install the IDE. That's the difference with the build tools.
And I should also point out, it installs things like the developer command prompts so that you can still go in there and use those to build from the command line, for instance.
Right.
Okay, so that is the build tool SKU. Anything else you want to talk about that, or we want to transition?
The build tool SKU, as far as the C++ workloads are involved, I think for the entire thing, they're all X-copyable. So if you have an image of your CI server that you've set up, you can just x-copy the bits from one place to another instead of having to worry about getting an image with registry settings, et cetera, et cetera.
Great. So that should be super convenient for people. What other options do we have for folks who want to install Visual Studio compilers?
So you mentioned VS 2013. And you mentioned one path for people.
Right.
And what was your solution for that again?
Upgrade.
So if you're in the position where, say, you are maintaining a legacy product and you still need the VS 2013 compilers, but you want to use all the goodness of VS 2017, what do you do? Oh, you're interviewing me. Right, got it. What you do, we have something called native retargeting, where if you install Visual Studio 2013 and Visual Studio 2017, you can actually use the VS 2013 compilers from VS 2017.
Right.
And there's more about that on VC blog. It's called native retargeting. We have other options. You're still looking like you're waiting.
I am waiting, Matt. I'm waiting for you to talk about all of the many other great places.
If you're using VS 2015, the VS 2015 tools for a long time have been included with the VS 2017 installer.
Right. So if you have the IDE.
If you have the IDE.
You're not doing a build server, for instance, something where you are going to want to install the IDE.
Well, it's in the build tools as well.
Right.
So whether you're using the VS, the full VS install, or the build tools install, you can install the V140 toolset, which is the VS 2015 Update 3 toolset.
Got it. Okay, but what about, like, if you want the absolute cutting-edge latest version of our stuff?
You mean you're using VS 2017 tools?
Yeah, and in particular, like, the dailies. I'm trying to push you towards
the dailies. I thought you were talking about side-by-side.
Ah, no.
No. Okay, so many things to talk about.
Yes.
So we actually have daily builds that we do here of our compilers. That's what our devs, when they check in. We produce NuGet packages of those. And we distribute those through a NuGet server at myget.org. And so the idea is whenever we produce a build, bring up the code from the front end team, the libraries team, and the code gen team, we build a compiler tool set, turn it into a NuGet package, upload it to myget.org. You can go in the NuGet package manager inside of Visual Studio, set up our myget instance as a provider for that, and you can install a compiler toolset locally into a project so that when you compile, rather than using the compiler which was installed with Visual Studio, you get to use the daily builds.
Why would you want to do this?
So, say you are paying a lot of attention to modules, or C++ modules, or coroutines. Like these are a couple
of TSs.
There are a couple of. That sounds like jargon. What do you mean by that, Steve?
A technical specification for the ISO CPP specification.
So modules and coroutines are a couple of the TSs that have been sponsored by people on our team, and correspondingly, our compilers have the most complete implementations of either coroutines or modules. But because they're both TSs, they're in flux, they're in active development.
Experimental.
If you're using modules, you'll find that they change quickly from build to build. We've got people checking in work all the time to make them better and better. So if you have been using modules and you're interested in the cutting edge, getting the daily builds is a good way to know how up to date we are, like, you know, what the code looks like in our offices. Those are about 10 days away from where our devs sit.
It's not like we're going to expose people to, like, literally the build break.
We check in a bug. We're going to break your code. We go through many different build servers before we get to ones that we actually release.
Got it.
And those get updated maybe twice a week. So, again, information is on the VC blog.
Let's talk about the hopefully rare occurrence where you do run into a bug inside of our compilers. You can also use these techniques as well.
There are no bugs.
But let's just say.
So if you run into something that you might have thought was a bug.
Compiler developers.
We had something. So Visual Studio 2017, we have updates that include new compiler toolsets. So 15.0, 15.3.5, 6, and yes, those
at this point it'll be up to
15.6. Each one of these had a new MSVC toolset. And of course, those install in place on top of the one that you had previously.
Right, we'll upgrade you by default when you take an upgrade, right?
Right, so if you were using 15.5 and 15.6 was just released,
As
it was today, we will update the compiler on your system from 15.5 to 15.6. And of course, everything will be okay. But if it's not, because you're the one person who hit a bug, just that one, we actually have included an option that you can install the 15.5 toolset alongside with 15.6.
Right. So the idea here is we know that the most impactful mistake we could make is to insert a bug into the compiler that you depend on. And so this was based on a lot of feedback that we got from folks.
One person.
That it's the critical that you be able to control when you take those hits. And so if we should ship a mistake inside the compiler, of course we will work extremely quickly to try to get those fixed. And we have, on occasion, had to patch the compiler just to fix a issue that escaped us. But what you always have the option to do, starting in, I think for the first time in 15.5, we made it so that you can go back into the installer, select the previous any of the previous toolkits up until 15.4 and later, so that you can go and quickly get the one that you were working with before. We still recommend for folks, and we have a fairly good track record, joking aside, of having not shipped massive compiler mistakes, and so that will help you have the control over what to do if we should make a mistake for you. Of course, please report those bugs on developer community and we will jump on them quickly.
For those, you need to go to the individual components tab. They're not in the main page of the VS installer, but if you look at the tabs at the top, second tab in is individual components. You scroll down through the list and you'll see all of the compilers listed by the VS, the latest VS update. So the 15.3 compilers are actually the same minor version series as the 15.4. All of the updates that we made between 15.3 and 15.4 were extremely limited fixes for known bugs, and the code changes that we make, we know to be safe. We would be extremely surprised if there were any regressions at all. And so we have the 15.4 compiler, like you said, as well as the 5 and 6.
Yeah, and we'll continue that policy going forwards.
Right.
Anything else we want to cover in terms of how to get tool sets for Visual Studio?
Did we miss anything?
I don't think so. We got MyGit, we got the build tools for 2017, which are going to replace your 2015
build
set.
Tools. We got native retargeting.
Got native retargeting, laid out multiple side-by-side ones and be able to use them.
VS 2015 is included in VS 2017, as well as every release of the VS 2017 tools except for the 15.0.
If you are still using XP targeting, that is also available.
XP targeting is still available.
You can use it to get the SDKs as well as the compilers.
Steve doesn't want you to upgrade from XP. He just wants you to upgrade your VS.
Yes, exactly.
Right.
Yeah.
You can install your SDKs, although SDKs are compatible with previous SDKs. So the latest SDKs should work for you.
But we're hoping to be sort of your one-stop shopping for prepping tools.
Whichever tools you need, you should be able to find and install. And there's blog posts about all of this on the VC blog.
Okay. And so, yeah, by all means, go out there and hopefully you can use this information to modernize your build servers and be more effective.
Yep. Of course, the goal with all of this is to keep you unblocked, to keep you, you know, obviously, if you're maintaining legacy products, obviously, if there is one issue in the compiler, maybe we shipped that one mistake. Or you know, maybe you have some code that's incompatible with a modern compiler feature. But you should always be trying to move your code forward. Let us know if there's a reason you can't. Thanks.
All right. Thank you very much.